Hello everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to create multiple objects of a class in Java. So I'll be showing you two methods how to do this. One is the normal way of creating multiple objects, and another one is creating multiple objects by using a for loop and a list, okay, list to store these objects. So let's get started. So I'm just having here a sample class and a constructor and its function. So let me just explain this code. So this is our class student. Student is the name, and it has three data members are variables. One is the name of type string, roll number, marks, and type of type integer, and this is the constructor. So just assigns the value as n or m. So each is getting assigned to name, roll number, and marks respectively. And this is a function display. So display just displays the value. Okay, displays name, roll number, mark of each object over here. So this is the another template class, and this is the public static void main function. Just standard Java stuff. Okay, first let me do the first method. Okay, just creating normal multiple objects. So it's going to be, and to create an object, we need to have the class name, okay? So it's going to be student. Let me say the object name to be as S1. S1 equal to new student. And here we need to pass all those values. So here we are having name, roll number, and marks as the in the constructor. So we need to pass these three values over here. So for name, let me pass over here John, and for roll number, I'll pass 1. And for marks, I will pass 100. So this will be my object one, okay? First object, and let me just copy this exact code over here. Just paste it again. So this will be my object two or student two. And I will just change the stuff over here. So it will be something probably over here, and two, and marks will be as 100. So I will just go over here. Now, once I have just created the objects, I will just call function display, okay, to just display these values in this format, in this name, roll number, marks format. So for that I will do is s1 dot, just call the function, because a function of a class can be only accessed by the object. So it's going to be s2 dot display. We'll just save this, and we just run this code over here. Java C to compile. It's going to be Java, we have Java sample class. Just hit enter. So as you can see here, I am getting this output in this format, okay, name, roll number, marks, John 100, Ravi 200. So this first thing, three things corresponds to this object over here, and I'm calling the function, and these three things correspond to this object over here. So this works fine. This is like multiple objects, I guess. But the problem with using this method is that here, if you, let's suppose say that we need to create 100 students, okay, then there are going to be 100 students like these two. And in that case, what you will do is you will be just keep on creating objects. It's going to be S1, S2. S3, S4, till S100. So it will have like 100 lines of code, which, and you need to also have 100 lines of this display function. So 200 lines of code. So that is like highly repetitive. Okay. So to minimize our work, we will be using a for loop and a list of objects to do this. Okay. So I will also show you a live demo. I think that is the true multiple objects. Okay. So this is just like multiple objects, but this is just a static way of doing it. True multiple object is by using a list, you will be able to access all the objects. Okay. Using a for loop basically. So I will just show that method as well. So let me just delete this code first. First, let me declare a list, okay? And this list is used to store our objects of the class student, okay? So it's going to be like this. So it's going to be list of data type. So here our data type is going to be of type student, okay? So if you're just doing normal numbers, it's going to be of int over here, but we are going to have objects of the class student itself. So it's going to be list student, our list name. So it will be list. Yes, it's going to be the name of our student list equal to new array list. Okay, so this should be like this way, capital A and capital L, array list and student, and just this bracket. And another important thing is that you need to import the header file, okay, using list. So it's going to be import java dot util, okay, dot asterisk. So this means that we're importing all the packages that are present inside this util class, okay? So now we are done, and this is the syntax over here. What we are going to do is we're just going to push the object that consists of this name, roll number, and marks into this list of objects, okay? So first, let me have three arrays, okay? Let's have three arrays, one array to store name, roll number, and marks. So this is going to be like this. So it's going to be string, let my name array be na, okay? String na equal to, let us say it has A, B, and C be the namespace inside it, okay? Let me have also a roll number and a marks, which is of type integer. So it's going to be int rn equal to, let me have just 1, 2, 3, and int ma equal to, so this one is going to be the marks, so we put 80, 90, and 100, okay? So I'm storing this in an array format just to minimize the code, okay? Instead of just hard coding for each object, I will be extracting the data from this array. So these are just the names, you can keep like whatever may be your choice. Okay? So now let's go and create our for loop. So it's going to be for int I equal to 0, I less than 3, I plus plus. And the reason why I am putting I less than 3 is because I am having only 3 values here. Okay, 3 values in my list. So it's going to be 0, 1, 2 and 3 values there. So when it comes to 3, it's going to break the condition. So the reason is that I am having 3 values. So if I am having here 5 or 10 values over here, you can just put 10, the number here itself. Okay, so now what we are going to do is we are just going to create an object. Okay, so it's going to be student s1 be our object. So let us have s. Okay, so student s will be our object. S equal to new student, and here is the twist. Okay, so instead of passing the values, so what we did earlier, so we did like this: student s1 equal to new student, so we will pass the name, say Ravi, and we pass the mark, roll number and the mark like this. Okay, so same thing we are going to do here, but our name is present in this array, our roll number is also present inside this array, our marks is also present inside this array. So what we'll be doing here is that instead of just hard coding the name, we will pass the array index as we are having the I value to iterate throughout this array each time. Okay, so here I will put student na of I comma rn of I comma ma of I. Okay, and after this, this object will be having this particular values. Let's say our I value is 0. Okay, our I value 0 means these three values, a, 1, 80 will be present inside it, and this will be stored in s. And next line, what I will do is just go here, I will put list, which is this list, object list, list dot add s. Okay, so s is nothing but this object, okay, student object over here. So let me just explain it to you like clearly. So what happens is that, so student is there, this for loop is there, I'm creating just an object over here. So during the first iteration, okay, our I value will be 0. So our I will be equal to 0, and what happens is that these three values, a, 1 and 80 will be stored inside this s, and inside our main list, okay, this will be the, it's like list of 0. So list of 0 will be corresponding to a, 1 and 80. And during the next iteration, our I value will be 1. So 1 is nothing but b, 2 and 90. So this value will be stored in s, and again it will be added over here. So it will be added as list of 1. So list of 1 value will be b, 2 and 90. And same thing, when i value becomes 2, we will be adding c, 3 and 100 inside it. So list of 2 will be added over here. So it will be C300. So I hope this I made you clear, okay, how this works. And now once you're done adding all our values, we need to have access to that, right? So for that case, we will be using the get function. So it's going to be list dot get and the index value. So let's suppose say that I want access this object that has B2 and 90 as values. So this is actually present in 2-1, okay? It's actually present in list of 1. So this, but the problem with this is that you can't directly access by using index. Okay, so that's why we are using this get. So list of 1 consists of b2 and 90. So here I will just put 1 and I will call the function display. So I'll just call the function display to display the values present inside. So same thing, we just use this. After doing this, we did s1 dot display. Okay, so this is what we used, and instead of doing that, we are just having this person inside this list, and we are accessing the index, and we are just calling the function. Okay, so I hope I made sense there. So let me just run it now. So I'm not getting any error. So as you can see here, I'm getting B2 and 90. So this corresponds to B2 and 90, this thing. So if I just go here and put 2, 2 means this C3 and 100. Okay, so if you just go here and run it, as you can see, I'm getting C3 and 100. So let's suppose that you want all the details. Okay, so for that also you can do the same thing. We'll just copy this code, copy it, paste it, and instead of doing this stuff, you can just do list dot get of I dot display. That's it. So just compile and run it. So as you can see in the output, I will be having all the values. So it's having A180, B290, C300. So the only thing is that instead of hard coding or creating multiple objects, we have done by using a for loop itself, for loop and just three arrays. So this has like reduced the code considerably. Let's say that you're having 100 values, means you can just input the all the 100 values here, and you can just put a 100 here. Just I will be less than 100, I will be less than here. That's it, you're done with the code. So by doing this way, by using the for loop for creating multiple objects, you can just reduce the code size. Okay, so I just wanted to show you how you can use a for loop that can create multiple objects, hence reducing your code size. Okay, so I hope you have found this video useful. I also learned many other Java videos as well as C, C++, Python, as well as 3D animation in Blender. So do check out the rest of my channel, subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.